Welcome to ACG School Jakarta. My name is Sean Hutchinson and I'm the principal of this dynamic, diverse and family-friendly international school that is nestled in the heart of South Jakarta. We're a proud school that offers the International Baccalaureate Primary Years program from kindergarten to year six. Our middle school program from years 7 through 9 follows the Cambridge Lower Secondary curriculum and leads seamlessly into 2 years of high school where students in years 10 and 11 undertake Cambridge IGCSE courses and qualifications. Students work through the International Baccalaureate Diploma Programme or the ACG School Jakarta High School Programme over the final 2 years of high school. Our core values of excellence, partnerships, integrity and compassion drive our actions and behaviours. And we're all fortunate to work and learn in a safe and supportive and tight-knit community. Our students are given opportunities to take control of their learning, pursue their interests in sports, the arts, community service, develop leadership skills and initiate projects and activities that are relevant to their lives and their wider local and international communities. We want to empower our students and give them choices and opportunities to develop their creativity and critical thinking. We want our students and teachers to be innovative and embrace an entrepreneurial mindset. Our experienced and highly qualified teachers are recruited from around the globe and they are central to the learning success of our students. Our teachers are skilled practitioners and subject specialists who inspire our students, care for our students and guide our students to make the most of their opportunities and experiences. We hope that the virtual open day gives you the opportunity to learn a little more about our people, programs and campus. Most importantly, we hope that our virtual open day inspires you to make further inquiries to enrol your son or daughter for the 2020-21 academic year. We are open for learning.
Hello, I am Danu and we are your student ambassadors for today. As a tight-knit community, all members of our school, from staff to students and parents, we all value the relationships and inclusive environment we have established with each other.
And I'm Isabel, and we are your student ambassadors for today. Having both been part of ACG School Jakarta for numerous years, we are proud to say that ACG School Jakarta has flourished into a school which fosters children of all ages and of all backgrounds to become creative, open-minded, and confident people. Not only do our students come from diverse backgrounds, but being part of an international organization allows them to pursue astounding opportunities.
With world-leading international programs such as the IB and Cambridge curricula, all students are equipped with the 21st century skills needed in the modern environment. The events and programs run at ACG School Jakarta allow students to participate in school-based but also local activities. There's something for everyone, which lets them develop natural leadership and organizational qualities in fields they are passionate about.
From international sports tournaments to university acceptances from across various continents, ACG School Jakarta gives students the foundations on which they can build brighter futures.
Early childhood is a vital time in a child's learning and holistic development, and it is through play and inquiry that children are able to develop cognitively, physically, socially, and emotionally. I work with a team of highly skilled, experienced and passionate early years educators who encourage the students to pursue their individual interests. In this way, we can customise learning based on their unique needs, motivations and next steps in their development. We place great emphasis on growing children's conceptual understanding, along with important skills such as communication, social, self-management and problem-solving skills to equip them with the important tools they will need in later life. Through our carefully designed learning areas, there are endless opportunities for our students to be creative and think innovatively through the use of different tools, equipment, and open-ended materials. I often refer to us as a kindergarten family because over time, that is what we truly become. at ACG School Jakarta, building strong relationships with our parents is fundamental to everything we do. It is so rewarding to work together with parents and caregivers to support their child in reaching their full potential. It is wonderful to see such secure and confident learners who love to come to school each and every day.
Hi, I'm Najma. We are your student ambassadors for today. ACG School Jakarta is an international school suited for the 21st century learning. It is a school that shapes well-rounded students who are independent, creative, and open-minded.
We are a school of flexible teachers and students that can adapt quickly to the constantly changing world around us. We have established a culture where students take initiative and provide opportunities for the whole school to come together. Student leaders ensure students of all ages are involved in different aspects of school life. We are your student ambassadors for the day. The school is diverse with students from all around the world. It fosters internationalism and global citizens that are aware of the world around them. Students value strong relationships and inclusivity.
Hello, I'm the Learning Support Coordinator at ACG School Jakarta. My role is to coordinate a team of specialist teachers who support students requiring English language support and students with special educational needs. English language support students are guided in small groups to develop their confidence and skills in English through pull-out and in-class support in order that they can work more independently in the classroom. We also welcome students with special educational needs who are supported in the classroom working towards individual learning goals and in accessing the curriculum. Students are also supported through small group instruction outside of the class in literacy and numeracy as required. We also work with outside services and we can support parents and students in accessing these services.
My name is Wendy Hunter. This is my second year at ACG Jakarta and my first year as a senior teacher. I'm very passionate about the IB and I'm excited to share some introductory information regarding the Primary Years program. The Primary Years program is a transdisciplinary educational framework that at the core focuses on the development of approaches to learning, which include communication skills, research skills, social skills, self-management skills, and thinking skills. We believe the acquisition of these skills is critical to becoming a lifelong creative problem solver. Teachers work collaboratively to create units of inquiry that span across not only the core subjects of literacy, science, and maths, but also incorporate physical education, social education, and the arts. At ACG, we focus on educating the whole child through research-based, highly effective teaching models, such as our reading and writing workshop for literacy and inquiry-based mathematics with a strong focus on numeracy skills. Teachers and students are partners in learning and teaching, where reflection is a key part of the learning process. Students are able to work to create a growth mindset and make goals specific to where they want to be on their learning journey in the future. Teachers also provide individualized support, focusing on where the child is and where they want to go. We look forward to welcoming you to ACG Jakarta and answering any questions you may have.
I believe that to inspire a generation of young people to become entrepreneurs as educators, we too have to become pioneers within our own disciplines. In my field, that doesn't just mean technological expertise, but by allowing students to procure 21st century skills like content knowledge, critical thinking, collaboration, and leadership proficiencies helps prepare individuals to meet the challenges and opportunities of today's world and beyond. Once students are equipped with these skills and knowledge to create and make, if possible, I look for every opportunity to engage students in real-life scenarios. Doing this creates situations for sharing, either in forums or presentations, where conversations are necessary with not only their peers, but the local and wider communities. This formulates students with a sense of purpose and understanding of why and what they are doing. Having an open mind and continually asking questions allows us as schools to step out of our comfort zones whilst pushing boundaries. I also believe that it's important to make the most of every opportunity that's presented both inside and outside of the classroom. Whether you fail or succeed at a task is not important. What is important is what you take from that process and how you use that experience to become successful. That is the key test to success.
Hello, I'm Richard Todd and I'm the Vice Principal here at ACG School Jakarta. I've been here a year now, and what a year it's been. It's an interesting coincidence that what we were planning to attempt with the school before COVID-19 arrived has actually been made even more relevant since all of the new restrictions have made themselves felt. So we are still in the process of building a community of creative, entrepreneurial problem solvers, but now we will be using this situation as an opportunity to find different ways to show these characteristics, to develop these dispositions. We know it will be difficult, sometimes impossible, to do things in traditional ways, so we must allow ourselves space to innovate and give the permission and the challenge to the student community to help us make innovation and invention second nature, like a muscle memory. So if science labs, art rooms, and DT workshops are restricted in terms of use, then join with us and imagine how digital platforms can be used to find new ways to explore, experiment, to build, and to beautify. How about making a digital tour of famous art galleries, or maybe using junk materials in your house to construct simple machines and then make a documentary of the process? How about reading up on quantum mechanics and making an instructional video for Year 6 students? In truth, the more limitations we have, the more creative we have to be. And this new normal means that we are reinventing school, or at least how teaching and learning operates in this very different context. So let's embrace all of these restrictions and see them as opportunities to try something new and to retest our abilities.
Good morning, everyone, and a nice warm welcome to you all this fine Saturday morning. Lovely to see you all online. A nice warm welcome to prospective families, as well as staff and students, and some of our existing families as well. To begin with, I'm going to introduce a few people who are online to answer and respond to any questions that you may have this morning. Before I get into the introductions, there is a Q&A section online where you can post your questions, and we'll do our very best in the next 40 minutes or so to respond to as many questions as we can. But first of all, I'd like to introduce senior teachers and academic leadership team members of ACG School Jakarta. So first of all, our Vice Principal, Mr. Richard Todd. Perhaps a wave, Richard, and a good morning would be great. Vanessa Ellison, who is our senior teacher, PYP. Wendy Hunter, who is our senior teacher, assistant PYP. And Joanne Dickinson, senior teacher, SEN and ELS. And Ryan McPhee, who is our senior teacher for sport and PE. And we also have Mr. Brendan McTiernan, who is our team leader for humanities and ITGS teacher. Mr. Mark Ellison, our team leader for the arts and design technology teacher, and Mr. Josh Winnicky, our economics teacher, and Miss Charlene Chen, who is our year four primary teacher. And also we have a couple of student leaders joining us this morning. A nice warm welcome to Isabel. Isabel is our head girl, and she'll be speaking in a moment about our student leadership, and two of our prefects this morning, Rahim and Anne. Nice to have the both of you here. And we also have two members of our admin team, Miss Mia and Miss Scepter, who will be joining us as well. So a nice warm welcome to you all. Thanks very much for joining us. I'm now going to pass over to Isabel, who is going to just talk a little bit about our student leadership structure at ACG School Jakarta, and perhaps give us a little bit of a taste of what the student leaders have been up to this school year. Over to Isabel.
Good morning, everyone. It's really nice to see you all here. I'm the head girl for this year, and together with our head boy, who isn't present today, we are one of the leaders of our student council for both secondary and primary. We have support from three prefects, Rahim and Anne, who are here today, and Rebecca, who is also absent today. We have been working together with the secondary student council and also the primary student council to try and host and come up with events to help make virtual learning a bit more exciting and fun. Most recently, we had our virtual Spirit Week, which was a really big success, where we had different days where students could dress up as the themes on those days and some activities involved.
Great. Thanks very much, Isabel, for that little glimpse of the work that our student leaders have been doing this year. And congratulations to you all. You're doing a great job virtually to keep up that school spirit and keep our community connected. I'm now going to pass over to Miss Mia Sari to introduce herself and to share a few thoughts. Over to you, Mia.
Thank you, Pashan. Good morning, my name is Mia Sari and I run the admissions at ACG School Jakarta. Thank you for joining us at virtual open day this morning. I'm generally the first contact for families interested in enrolling their children, and I would be more than happy to meet you face to face with health and safety protocols or online to answer any of your questions about our school. I can also arrange time to meet with our academic leadership team if you have specific questions about our IB PYP, Cambridge, or IBDB program. For joining our virtual open day today, we're offering families some great incentives if you choose to enroll your son or daughter. If you would like to know more about our special offers, feel free to send me a quick message through email or leave a message in our website contact page.
Great. Thanks very much, Mia, for those words. We are now opened up for Q&A, and we will wait for some questions to come in. As we are waiting for questions, I'm actually going to pass over to Rahim and Anne just to share with us their thoughts on virtual schooling this year, just briefly. So Rahim, we'll start with you if that's okay.
Thank you, Mr. Hutchinson. Good morning, everyone, parents. My name is Rahim, and I'm one of the prefects at ACG School Jakarta. And virtual schooling has been overall pretty great. We have transitioned quite smoothly from being in person at school to being in a virtual environment. And we've seamlessly changed our ways of learning online. And we've been developing how we're supposed to learn online. And we have been coping with the challenges such as like not being able to properly contact with teachers. Now we're able to contact more often using our platforms such as Microsoft Teams, Zoom. They've just made our experience seamless, and we're all able to contact with each other more often. We can get help with each other more often, and our communication platforms just helped us a lot. And the Microsoft Office platforms also proven quite useful in being more productive and efficient in producing work and submitting to our teachers.
Great, thanks very much for those words, Rahim. Anne, can you share us a little bit of insight into your experiences through virtual schooling?
Thank you, Mr. Hutchinson. Good morning, everyone. I'm Anne, and I'm also one of the prefects for ACP School Jakarta. My experience with virtual schooling has been pretty smooth, I think. There have been a lot of challenges, but communicating with teachers is pretty vital if you want to kind of get your concerns across to the academic leadership team. And I have been asking teachers a lot of for assistance in my virtual schooling, and it has been really, really great because they listen to my concerns and they take it into consideration. And I'm really grateful for that.
Great, thanks very much for that, Anne. We do have a question at the moment. It's in relation to our student class sizes in the primary school. I'm going to pass over to Miss Vanessa, who might be able to respond to this question.
Hi, good morning, hi. So we currently have one primary class per year level. So that's, we have the kindergarten, and then we have years 1 to 6. And on average, I would say about 16 students per class on average.
Great, thanks very much for that, Vanessa. While you're online, perhaps you can share with us your insights into the kindergarten this year, and then I'll pass over to Wendy to share her thoughts on primary school and virtual schooling.
Interestingly, we have a question here about virtual schooling program for kindergarten and primary this year. And I have to say, you know, we're really, really proud of all the work that we've done with our virtual school program. We think it's been really successful. We have been very proactive in making sure that we have responded to feedback from our ACG community, our parents and caregivers, because, you know, they are the ones that are doing such an amazing job with their children each and every day. We run a synchronous virtual school program, and so by that we the students will log into a live Zoom, and we're very conscious about screen time, so we make sure that our Zoom sessions for each subject do not exceed 20 minutes, and then they will have a follow-on activity which they can do independently with a grown-up, and these are all developmentally appropriate for the age and the subject. We have worked really hard to make sure that the activities and the work that they do is exciting, it's hands-on, it's a balance between on-screen activities. There are things where they will do and make and draw and create, so we really wanted to make sure that that creativity and the problem solving is very evident in what they do at home. And so we're continuing to work on this, and you know, we're we're continuing to work with the students and the families to make sure it's the very best virtual school delivery that it can be. But I'm really proud of the primary team. I'm so proud of the families and all the work that we're doing. And the children are having fun and making progress.
Thanks for that, Vanessa. I will pass to Wendy, because Wendy, you will have some thoughts on virtual schooling experience in the primary school as well.
Yes, primarily in upper primary, so years 4 through 6. Just feeding on what Vanessa was saying, we really do want to have that balance of using technology and then letting them use traditional materials. So I think it's kind of forced our children to be a lot more independent, a lot more student agency going on, because we'll have optional Zooms and support Zooms, but they have to be the ones that are aware of when they need that additional support and come and seek it out from us. And so I'm seeing the independence in the upper primary just kind of going through the roof. They're starting to really think about, do I understand this? Do I need help? And then they have to be the ones to come and ask for support in those areas. The activities are different, a lot more creative. Students are doing their own tutorials where they might be teaching their classmates about a concept that they've already mastered, or they might be doing a keynote or PowerPoint, or they might be doing pic collage. And the amount of different learning platforms that they've learned this year is tremendous, and they have a lot of fun doing so. Now we have our drive-through library open, so they're really excited about coming in and getting some more hands-on learning materials. And so it's really kind of becoming a nice blend of traditional school with the virtual school, and things are going well, and I'm happy to see such excitement throughout the primary years program.
Thanks very much, Wendy. Charlene, I'll pass to you now. Working in the primary school and particularly through this virtual school experience, have you got any additional comments to make there?
Well, my students have, using Zoom, I actually put it onto them to actually teach themselves and teach me how to operate Zoom. That gives them that student agency. They were really amazing. They actually ended up being the support people for kids who are struggling with specific things within Zoom. And it was really quite amazing to see them engaged in that platform as well. So they were the ones who were learning all about whiteboard and how to share screen and how to annotate and so forth. And then they were actually the ones teaching each other, teaching me as well. And it was fantastic. Yeah.
Great.
So technology is great.
Thanks, Charlene, for that. That's great. Joanne, I will pass over to you to respond to the question about languages offered at our school.
Okay, thank you, Sean. So the question is regarding Chinese as a language, whether we offer it or not. In line with the Indonesian requirement for Indonesian children who are enrolled in the school must take Bahasa Indonesia or Bahasa Indonesia as a foreign language as their second language. Now, if you have a child who is not registered at the school as an Indonesian student, they will have the option of taking Bahasa Indonesia as a second language, or Chinese Mandarin. So yes, we do offer Mandarin as a second language or first language, depending on the amount of exposure that the student already has. And I believe that begins in, sorry, Miss Vanessa, what grade does that begin with in primary?
Grade four.
Okay, so that will begin in year 4 and that runs all the way through to secondary school. In actual fact, we also offer Mandarin and Bahasa Indonesia foreign language as an IGCSE course as well. So skills are developed throughout the school. And then when they get into the upper grades, there's an opportunity to take examinations, formal examinations in one of those subjects.
Excellent. Thanks very much for that. We do have a question about scholarships. It's a question that always comes up, and we do have a number of scholarships available to students across particular year levels. The scholarships that I think worth mentioning at this particular point in time are our academic scholarships. They are merit scholarships. We do have IBDP scholarships. They are full scholarships for students beginning the IBDP program. They are very competitive and they're very limited, but they are for students who are able to demonstrate through their previous school experience a high level of academic performance or contribution to school through sporting pursuits or the arts or community service. So those scholarships are highly sought after and are available for students entering the IBDP program at year 12. We also have scholarships available for students in the primary school and the middle school, and they are based on the family's circumstances and situation. We have obviously sibling family scholarships available. We have a tuition fee assistance program that's available for families who are in need of additional support to reach our tuition levels. In terms of the amounts, they can range from anywhere from 5% through to 50% reduction in tuition fees. If you have specific questions, and again, it's generally based on your circumstances as a family, but if you've got some questions about scholarships beyond what I've just mentioned, please contact Mia Sari and she'll be able to respond to you based on your circumstances. So that being said, we will repeat some of the information about class sizes because we've already covered that this morning, but we'll put that into the chat response for those of you who missed that earlier. I just want to pass over to Mr. McPhee to talk a little bit about our sporting opportunities throughout our school prior to COVID, and then what it may look like post-COVID.
Thank you, Mr. Hutchinson. We do have a very robust sporting program here at ACG. At the high school level, we compete in several different conferences. One of our conferences is ASAC, and that's an international conference in the sports of volleyball, soccer, basketball, and swimming. And there's also other events in ASAC that are non-sporting, like STEM and math. Locally, we're in conferences here in Jakarta. For high school students, it's the South Jakarta Athletic Conference. For our upper secondary students and at the middle school level, we compete in the Jamisa League, which is another local conference. In primary school, we have several options in swimming and soccer. We're part of the Jakarta Schools Football League, and that's our offerings for sports at the current moment.
Great. Thanks very much for that, Ryan.
You're welcome.
And Vanessa.
And there's just a question here from Dr. Valentine G. So this is regarding a session on early childhood education for 1 to 3 year olds. I do run sessions for parents and certainly last year we ran some live face-to-face sessions. So of course, at the moment they will be virtual. So we actually did a webinar on Friday, that's available on our ACG website. So you're on our YouTube channel. So you're able to have a look at what we have currently delivered in terms of sessions for parents. But I actually do work in school every day. So if you do want to, when you do a visit with Miss Mia, I'm more than happy to talk more about the early childhood curriculum at ACG School Jakarta. So we can arrange that for you and I can talk in much more detail about that. But yes, we do run sessions and I am really excited to do more of them this year, even if they're virtual. So yes, we will.
Great. Thanks very much for that, Vanessa. One of the focus points for us as a school is around helping students develop creative skills, problem-solving skills, developing entrepreneurial and innovation skills. And so I'm going to pass over to Richard and Mark, who perhaps share with us some examples that have taken place over the past little while and what we're looking forward to moving forward. So start with Richard, if we can.
Hi, yeah, thanks, Sean. Well, it's one of the central directions or central pushes, if you like. One of the things that we're trying to do throughout the school, it's not just in the secondary school, it's not just in the middle school, we're trying to inculcate, we're trying to bring in innovation, entrepreneurial behaviors within classrooms. So some of the things, you'll find that a lot of PYP units of inquiries, but one of the most exciting things that's being planned right now, I know that there's a unit that's being planned by several teachers within the secondary school. So it's what you might call, I've forgotten the phrase. Help me out, Mr. Ellison. It's an IDU, an interdisciplinary unit. Where did that go? I've been too long out of the classroom. An interdisciplinary unit where teachers and students are working together so that students can explore and research and produce along the lines of a real world problem. So it's very much like what you might do in a design classroom, but bringing in an awful lot more curricular areas. Mark, do you want to sketch out, without giving too much away, what the students are talking about?
Well, hi everyone, my name's Mark Ellison and I teach years 7 to 11 in the high school for design technology. And I won't lie to you, it's been a very, very difficult time in terms of the design space, not being able to use the facilities. But what has come out of this experience is that students now are actually opening up their minds to think differently, try to solve problems in ways that they wouldn't normally or necessarily solve problems. So I've actually seen a very big shift and a change in the way students are actually applying themselves to design in the field of design technology, which has been exciting for myself. Just to touch a little bit on what Richard's saying with the IDU that we are planning, what's been really, really great to see is the collaboration that's been happening amongst teachers, right? Amongst the staff. Students seem to be really excited about the prospect of this new unit that we're introducing. And I can say that it is really exciting, and it's something that I'm sure you will get to see the end product as we go on throughout the academic year. So yes, I don't really want to give too much away. I just want to say, speak to your students, speak to your children, ask them what's actually happening, what they're doing, what their interests are, what they're really enjoying, whether they're not. It's all been a positive experience. It was difficult because from my point of view, it was a subject there where they're normally hands-on and have been taken, it's thrown a complete 360. And it's been really good to see how they've dealt with the situation and have come through on it. So yeah, watch this space.
Thank you. Thank you ever so much, Mark. In addition to that, one of the things that we've started, I've noticed this as a real opportunity. And I mentioned that in my little video section there. But one of the things that the students have done, and we can learn more about this from the head girl, Isabel, the students have taken on the challenge of looking after the school assemblies, which we do once a month. And so what the work that goes into putting these things together, it's a real masterclass in problem solving. They take a 30-minute block and they get news and events from all around the school in the last month. They do the transitions, and we have the wonderful help of our librarian staff as well, putting these things together. We have a radio station that is working remotely. They're just working on interviews right now, student-run, student-initiated as well. So it's within classes, it's combined classes, and it's extracurricular as well. So yeah, putting the challenge before students as well as before members of staff, how can we use this this situation and not see it just as a difficulty, but an opportunity, and everybody's responding really well.
Great, thanks very much, Richard and Mark. I'm gonna throw to Brendan McTiernan, who is our team leader for humanities. He's also our ITGS and Global Perspectives teacher. Brendan, if you could just share a couple of comments about MUN, what is it, and what have our students been involved in? You'll need to put your microphone on, Brendan. Yep, that's it.
Okay. Hi, everyone. Thanks for coming this morning. So MUN is Model United Nations, and what it is a debating conference between international schools based on the procedures of the United Nations itself. So at the moment, we're preparing for Taiwan, which is starting on November the 16th, and students are preparing and researching on policies of Malaysia and UN policies on specific motions related to the committees on the UN. So at the moment, we're working on policy papers, we're working on draft resolutions, and we're working on our speeches as well. So we're making progress in those areas, still lots of work to do. But from the students' point of view, it's already helping them to hone their research skills. And in terms of their critical thinking skills, when they're putting together their speech and their draft resolution, they're improving their analysis and evaluation skills as they go through that. And as they're doing it online, as Mr. Ellison was saying, they are having to be a little bit more innovative in how they research and how they get over the difficulties of actually getting this done in terms of interacting more with teachers and using online tools to do that. So far, it's going quite well, and hopefully we'll do very well on November the 16th.
Great. Thanks very much, Brendan. One of the more common questions that we receive from prospective families is, what are our students like? And so I'm going to ask Mr. Winicky just to talk a little bit about his views on our IBDP students, so students at years 12 and 13.
Hi, yeah, good morning, everybody. Thanks for joining us. Yeah, so let me give you the very first impression that I ever had of this current year 13 student. And it was actually, I believe, our first or second day of school last year. I still don't know anybody. I was a brand new teacher last year. I walk into my economics class and the students, they barely know me. And they're singing happy birthday to me. It was my birthday that day. I hadn't told anybody. It's not like I was showing this off. And immediately, like, they're trying to get to know me. And all this is to say, I can unequivocally say, these are without a doubt the nicest students I have ever had of any school ever anywhere, right? And that's probably speaking even to my experience as a student. You know, I can say, you know, even when I look at things that they have done in terms of like teacher appreciation days, you know, the willingness that they have gone to get to know me and show that they understand me has really made me feel welcome at this school right away. But take that even a step further, and that's the kindness that they show to teachers, but the kindness that they show to each other extends even beyond that. And so when I look at their efforts to get other students involved in activities and athletics, fantastic, right? When I look at their willingness to help other students out in academics, amazing, right? And so, you know, that is one side of it, is the social piece. And then the academic piece, whew, man, they're about some learning. It's fantastic. In terms of teaching it, look, my experience at this school is that it's amazing, right? Like every day, like I'm thinking of different ways of how I can get my students to think about our content. But in terms of the student body and their willingness to learn, the connections that they are willing to make, and they're just like constantly interacting with the material, right? So I could say this student will remain nameless, right? But there is a student in this meeting, right? Where not only does this student want to talk about economics, but I'm getting updates on Teams about the election in the US and what kind of conclusions can we draw and when are we gonna get results? And like, this approach to learning is just like, there's not really an off switch, and it's amazing, right? And I think like that kind of attitude is infectious. And so just my brief experience at ACG and interacting with the IBDP cohort has been nothing but fantastic. I have nothing but great things to say about the students in years 12 and years 13.
Great, thanks very much for your thoughts there, Josh. I am going to throw back to Isabel, Rahim, and Anne, and perhaps just share with our audience an experience that you've had at school outside of the classroom that you believe is an experience that you're going to remember for a very long time. We'll start with Isabel.
So there's been a lot of experience that I could talk about in this school that I'm just really proud that we achieved, not only myself, but the students involved. So for instance, like student council or even house teams. But I think one of the most memorable experiences was when I was a prefect last year, we had a Christmas event where we were making baked goods and selling them to students throughout the school as a fundraiser. And I was one of the bakers, and that in itself was already like really fun, alongside organizing the event with the entire student council, but also having teachers involved. I know Mr. Todd was involved as a Santa Claus that year, and one of the other teachers. And just seeing how we could bring like happiness to the students, especially the younger ones. And they were like, oh, I got gifts, I got food. That was just really rewarding to see. And yeah, it made me really like feel fulfilled to see that I could have such an impact on these students.
Great, thanks for that, Isabel. Rahim, over to you. Do you have an experience outside of the classroom that you'll remember for a long time?
I think yes. Even though I've only been at ACG School Jakarta for a year in like a in-person environment in the school, I think it's been great. Like the internationalism and like the friendships that I've made with the people there, the lunch tables, it's just the most memorable parts that I will have. The year 11s last year used to be together at the lunch tables, and I hope in the future we can join again in person as year 12s when hopefully the school reopens. Other parts that I liked are the secondary sports carnivals and the swimming carnivals, which I had in year 10 and year 11. Those were quite fun. The year 11s, they enjoyed together. We had fun and partied and stuff. It was quite fun.
Great. Thanks very much, Rahim. And over to Anne.
Well, I would say my experience last year in person with all the students in year 10, it was really like, how should I say? It was a really rewarding experience because all the students are really cohesive, I would say. We all support one another, and it was really shocking to me because I hadn't experienced something like that at my old school. And so times like being said during lunch, we would all talk together, or some would go out to the soccer field and play soccer with one another. It was really nice to see everyone, I guess, hanging out and being friendly with everyone. And maybe events like the camping trip last year to Bogor for IGCSE students. It was really, really fun. I really enjoyed it because we got to go outside and experience like outdoor activities with the local teachers. And it was like really, really fun. I wish I could have like went back again with all my friends.
Great, thanks very much for that, Anne. I'm actually going to ask Joanne to respond to the question about middle school, if that's possible, please.
Okay, so for the class numbers, I would say on average in secondary school, the same as Miss Vanessa said for primary,
would be average around 18 students, Mr. Hutchinson, if I'm not wrong, not 100% right, you know. Now, if we're thinking about middle school, our middle school is years 7 to 9, and each week consists of 40 periods. The subjects the children will study are 5 core subjects. The core subjects are math, English, global perspectives, science, and a second language, as we mentioned earlier. And generally those subjects will have 6 periods per week. The other classes will be PE, art, design technology, help me out, Mr. Todd.
Music.
That's it, yeah. And so that would take up the other 15 periods, and we also have an advisory. So in primary school, the students will have a homeroom teacher who will take care of the students throughout the year in terms of their pastoral care and their academic development and social development. When the students go into secondary, they will have an advisor. So each student will be placed into an advisory group and will have one teacher who is assigned to be their advisor. So I'm an advisor, Mr. McTiernan is an advisor, Mark is an advisor, Ryan is an advisor. And every day we will meet with our students, usually for the last period of the day, we'll come together with our advisory group and, you know, see how things have been going and work on some health and personal development with the students.
Great, thanks for that, Joanne. And I guess similarly with the primary school, Charlene and Wendy, could you perhaps just give us just a brief kind of insight into the daily structure for primary school students?
Yes, of course. So for upper primary, we have, I believe, around 21 periods per week that are dedicated towards our PYB program, units of inquiry, literacy, and mathematics. More often than not, those courses are integrated together. So we might be spending the beginning of a class doing work on our unit, but then we would be including literacy within that same time period. In addition to that, students in upper primary will take a foreign language, whether or not that's English language support, Chinese Mandarin, or Bahasa Indonesia. We also do Indonesian studies, and we have visual art, music, and physical education.
And library,
yep. And then we have a morning break time where students can have a snack or do some playing. And then we have our lunch period as well.
Great. Charlene, anything to add there?
So the schedule is a combination of asynchronous and synchronous classes. So synchronous means that you're online with the teacher, and asynchronous is when they are doing their own work outside of Zoom. That way we can keep the balance with screen time and so forth. And most of our subjects are integrated. So yes, you will have you could have a combination where you have the UOI, which is the unit of inquiry, that also links in with the literacy and the numeracy as well. So that's and how that works in the week is determined by the students as well. In my class, we also have student-led meetings, which is great, at the end of the week. And so that gives a chance for all our students to lead a meeting. They do the introduction, the welcoming, the introduction, and the closing, which is fantastic. So that's what I do in my class.
Great, thanks very much for that. As is always the case, towards the end of a session like this, we start to get more questions. So just a couple of questions that I will respond to. One around child safeguarding regulations and policies to protect children. So we are a part of a larger group of schools, Inspired Education, which is a UK-based education organisation. There are 65 schools in the group. So all of our child safeguarding policies and procedures are global procedures that ensure that our staff are provided with some training. So we use a platform called EduCare, where staff are able to access child protection training online. We also have a number of other procedures in place to ensure the safety and well-being of our students and our staff at ACG School Jakarta. So I hope that answers your question there. We do take child protection and safety very, very seriously at our school, and we want to ensure a very safe and comfortable environment for students, staff, and also for parents. The next question is around students with learning challenges. I am going to pass over to Joanne very, very briefly. Do we accept students with learning challenges, and what kind of programs do we have in place?
Oh, yeah. When you said briefly, I was just going to say yes. yes, we do accept children with learning difficulties. During the admission process, if you complete the admission form indicating that your child may have learning difficulties with supporting evidence in case you've had an educational assessment, and then we'll take it from there. So yes, we are an inclusive school. We do accept children with learning difficulties, and but we need to see if we can support that student. So you need to, during the admission process, make sure that you give us any supporting documentation that you have.
Excellent, thank you very much. Another question about entry tests. The admissions process does not require entry assessment. However, depending on the outcome of the interview, as well as the academic records that are provided, we may end up asking a student to take a particular test, particularly in literacy and numeracy. But generally speaking, once we've collected the information about the academic an educational background of each child, we make an admissions decision based on that information. Again, it's really important through the admissions process and application process that our families provide as much information as possible through the application. We are out of time, unfortunately, this morning. I just want to extend my thanks to the prospective parents who have joined us this morning, as well as our existing parents who have joined us for our virtual open day. Thank you very much for attending, and please contact Mia directly. Mia will be reaching out to all of you anyway following up this virtual open day, and we'd love to have submit an application for your son or daughter's enrollment to ACG School Jakarta. And finally, a big thanks to our panelists this morning who have joined us, looking fabulous as always, online and also face-to-face, mind you. But a big thank you to you. It's been a very quick virtual open day. If you've got other questions that we haven't been able to get to, or you think of a question after we close this virtual open day, please reach out to us, because we're more than happy to respond to any questions that you have. Have a wonderful weekend, everyone. Please stay safe. Please don't be strangers. Come and visit us. We do have health and safety protocols in place. You can come onto campus to have a look at our facilities, to meet some of the staff who are working. Thank you very much for your attendance. Have a great day. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye.